Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a list box in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright, you wonderful people, let's create a list box. A list box is a listing of selectable text items within its own container. So, as always, we'll need a window, window equals tk, followed by window.main loop. Let's create a list box simply called list box. Big surprise there, right? So, list box equals list box. What are we adding this list box to? We're going to place that here within the parentheses of the constructor. We're adding this to our window, and then we're going to follow this with list box dot pack. You can also do listbox.place as well and place some coordinates, but we've always done pack. Let's just stick with that for now. All right, so this is what our list box looks like. It's a small rectangular box, and we're going to add some text items that are selectable, and eventually we'll be able to submit a choice. So I have an idea. Let's create an online menu, like we're ordering food from a restaurant. Let's say it's Bro's Italian restaurant. So let's add some food items to our menu and somebody can submit an order. So we'll need to use the insert function of the list box to add some items. So listbox.insert. We place an index and a text item. So let's say for index one, we'll have pizza. And this is what we end up with. We have the item pizza, it's selectable. And, well, that's really it. We'll need to create a submit button and populate the rest of this list box. So let's add a few other items for our menu. So let's say we'll have 5 items. And we need an index for each. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we have pizza for the first item. For the second item, let's have pasta. And third, let's say garlic bread, because garlic bread is awesome. And restaurants usually have appetizers, so why not soup and salad? And that should be enough for this example. And this is what we have. We have our menu, and we can select an item from this menu. So let's customize the appearance of this menu. Well, because we can. So let's do that. Let's change the background color. So we do that with the option BG for background, and you can set this equal to a color of your choice or a hex value. So I have a hex color value already picked out. It is F7FFDE, and this has the appearance of, I would say, paper, like it's kind of faded. I think that would fit some sort of menu for a restaurant, but pick whatever background color you want. So let's change the font next. So we can do that with the option font, and I will pick the font Constantia. It's somewhat fancy. I think it would fit like a restaurant menu. And then a size of 35. Yeah, we're getting somewhere. We can also change the width and the height. So width equals, let's say 12. That's not too bad for a width. Let's also change the height. So we can do that with a function of our list box. So let's get the current size of the list box. And let's actually do that after we insert all of the items within our list box. So to change the size of our list box, what we do is type in listbox.config. You usually use config if you need to change any options. And we want to change the length of, or the height of this list box. So we're going to say height equals listbox.config. Size function. So then this will adjust the size of our list box dynamically. Even if we were to remove an item, then the size of our list box is going to shrink. Just like that. But let's keep salad in there for now because we need salad. All right, so how do we actually submit one of these options? We'll need to create a submit button. So let's do that after we create our list box. So near the bottom, we'll call this submit button. Submit button equals button. We're adding this to our window. Let's set the text to submit, and we'll need a command. So we'll create a function called submit. And then we need to pack this submit button. Submit button dot pack. Now at the top of this program, let's create a submit function. So at the top, def submit. So to retrieve or get the current selected item of a list box, there is a certain function that you can use. So we'll begin by saying listbox.get. What are we getting? We want to get anything that is currently selected, and there is a function for that. So what we're going to do within the parentheses of the get function is type in listbox.currentSelection. It's shortened to CUR selection. All right, and then we can either store this within a variable or we can just print this, but I think we'll just print this to keep it simple. Now, when we select an item and click on the submit button, it's going to submit our order. Actually, better yet, let's actually print you have ordered whatever item that we select. So garlic bread. You have ordered garlic bread. Cool. What we're going to work on now is a way to submit or insert an item to our list box after this program is compiled and already running. So we'll create an entry box within our window where we can submit a custom item to this menu. So let's create an entry box, and let's do that before the submit button. That would be a good spot for this. So let's call this entry box where somebody can type in something to add to the menu. So entry box equals entry, and we're adding this to our window, and then entry box dot pack. Then we're going to create a button called add, and I'm just going to copy everything from the submit button, and we'll change submit to add. We're going to add an item to the menu. So we'll change the text to add and command add. Add button dot pack. Then we're going to create a function called add, and we'll do that at the top. Def add parentheses colon. So to add an item to the list box, first we need to get what is currently in the entry box. So we can do that by typing in listbox.insert. Then within the parentheses, we need to get an index number as well as a text item. So for the number, what we can type here is the listbox.size. So this will give us the current position of the index that we're currently on for the list box. And then we need to get the text in the entry box. So we type in the name of the entry box dot get. And this will insert a new item within our menu, our list box. So let's try it again. So we can type in an item, let's say soda. We want to add soda to the menu, and then we click add. All right, there's our soda, but we have to scroll down to see it. So let's change the size of our list box. So there's actually a line of code that we did that already. Listbox.config height equals listbox size. So let's add that within the add function at the very end. So then the height of our list box will adjust. So currently there's no soda within our menu. Let's type in soda or some other item, click add, and then that item will appear and the size of the list box will change to accommodate any new items. Let's say now that we serve sushi, we're now an Italian and Japanese restaurant. Now we have sushi on the menu. You know what? Why stop there? Let's create a delete button to delete an item from this menu. So we'll create a delete button. I'll just copy everything for add and change this to delete. So delete button, text equals delete, command equals delete as well, and delete button dot pack. And then at the very top, we'll create a delete function. So we'll do that here. Def delete. And to delete an item from a list box, there's actually a function to do that. So listbox dot delete. And then within the parentheses of the delete function, we can pass in listbox dot current selection, or just CUR selection for short. And then we want to readjust the height of this list box after we delete an item. So we'll just add listbox dot config height equals listbox.size because the size of all the items within the listbox is going to shrink after we delete an item. So let's try this. So here's our menu. Let's say we no longer want salad because salad is healthy. Well, we can delete it. Same thing with soup. And you know what? Let's also delete the pasta and the pizza. So we're only left with sweet, sweet garlic bread. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get into some more advanced stuff with list boxes. What if you want to select more than one item from this list box? We're going to need to change a few things. So when we create our list box, there is a select mode, and we are going to set this equal to multiple. So now we can actually select multiple items from this list box. Like, I want to select one of everything. But what happens when we submit this? Well, we're going to run into some problems, so we're going to need to change this program around. So let's begin with the submit option. So what we're going to do within the submit option is first get rid of this line. Let's say we no longer need this anymore. And then before we print out the items that we ordered, let's create a list called food. And we'll just leave this empty for now and we'll fill this later. So we'll create a for loop for index in listbox.currentSelection. What we're going to do after each iteration, food.insert our index number as well as listbox.get the item name at this index. What this for loop is doing is that it's going to iterate once for each item that we select. So since we have three items that are currently selected, this is going to iterate three times, get the index number as well as the item at that index number. And now we just need to display the contents of what we have within our list of food. So we can do that with another for loop. So let's add that after you have ordered, then for index in our list food. All we'll do is print index. So this will print out everything that we ordered. So let's say that we want one of everything and submit this. You have ordered pizza, pasta, garlic bread, soup, and salad. Now, what happens if we try to delete multiple items? So let's say we want to delete soup and salad, and we click delete. Well, we're going to run into an error because our function is not set up to accommodate for multiple items. So we'll need to change a few things around. So let's get rid of this line for now, listbox.delete, listbox.currentSelection. And we're going to place a for loop here. So for index in listbox.currentSelection. Then after each iteration, what we're going to do is use listbox.delete, and we're deleting the item at whatever index we're currently on. So you would think this would work at first glance. Let's say we want to delete pizza and pasta. We're going to click delete. So pizza was deleted, but not pasta. That's because the indexes are changing after we delete an item. So when we use this for loop, we should actually reverse this. So with listbox.currentSelection, we are going to enclose this with reversed. So then we're going to start at the last index and work our way to zero in that order. So now if we want to delete pizza and pasta, I don't know why we would because they're amazing, and we click delete, it deletes pizza and pasta, but we still have garlic bread, soup, and salad. Then we can add an item. Let's say we want to add sushi again to the menu. We can do that, and then we can order one of everything because we're really hungry. You have ordered garlic bread, soup, salad, and sushi. So that's the basics of creating a list box in Python. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of list boxes in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.